Welcome everybody for today's IHF Skills for All session about the Swiss recruitment program and their quality management system. If you want to be successful, grow or successfully growing the game, there is no question that the main fundamentals are recruitment and a successful experience at youth level. In our opinion, as Youth and Junior Development Committee, we must pay attention to this topic on a regular basis and show you some good benchmarks which can inspire or help you. And if you would have a very good example or benchmark, please notify us because we can always use good examples. We will not only talk about getting new players in the program, but also about the quality of your program to connect them to the sport of ice hockey. It's a great pleasure to introduce our presenter for today. It's also a member of our Youth and Junior Development Committee and the Director Youth Sport and Development of the Swiss Ice Hockey Federation, Mr. Markus Graf. Welcome, Markus, and thank you for accepting our invite to be our presenter for today. Before we start, and as usual, if you have any question to our presenter, you can post those in the chat box or use the raise hand function and we will address the question during the session. Markus, welcome. The floor is yours.
Thanks, Johan. Hello, everybody. Hi, guys. First of all, I'm very pleased to be here to speak to the hockey world, having a great, hopefully a great hour of hockey during summertime. And I'm honored to ask me about, to talk about Swiss ice hockey. I'm quite went through in my career to all the function of youth development as a player, as a coach, as a GM, all over. By side, my job is teaching overall. So I got a good experience in school to bring into hockey. So first of all, I like to congrats you guys. You're here, you spend time not only on hockey, on the hockey field to grow the game. You decide to listen, to share, and to make a new experience within this sessions. I think that's part of, and I think this hour is here for to make you stronger in confidence. You see what you do, you're right on the right way. Maybe a confirmation of things you already established. If you get out of our way to work, one idea that you can might implement in your hockey world, and I will be happy. And overall, these sessions for me, they're always like a little moment of reflection, how I am as a coach, what I'm doing, what I'm focused on, and what I can improve. So a wonderful thing you decide to join us, and hopefully I can deliver some ideas for you. You make you happy in the future of your hockey world. Let's give us a little bit an overview about Swiss ice hockey, where we come from, where we're going, and where we battle. So you know about what's our challenge and where we are working at. Are we a hockey country? Wonderful picture, and it's a little bit of teasing our country. That's the promotion picture on the World Championship 2009. But to be honest, I'm sorry if there is any guy from Canada, that's a stolen picture of a lake or in Canada. So we're really kind of smart sometimes. But about talking about facts and figures, where we are. We are a kind of small nation in numbers. That means overall of 8 million people around, it's all stat, but I think the big picture is anyway the same. We compete and we dream to be these big guys, this big hockey nation. So means with 15,000 youth players, we cannot afford to do many as mistakes. We put up good roster on top level. We cannot afford to do many mistakes on youth hockey. Having them involved in a growing fun game or senior leagues. That's a thing we have to know. But we are such a great hockey nation in sense of emotion and fans all over. Not only for the national team, we have really a great background on fans for the national team. And here, in Europe. And what is it? Is it this related to youth hockey? Maybe yes, but yes, I think, because I believe if we put up to young people such great events, if we can catch them with emotion about our game, it's on the ice, of course, to deliver the fun, but by sight, to make them dream, that's part of. So it's even to a reflection to recruitment hockey, I believe. About Swiss hockey, that's a great topic ongoing. Is our what we do, where we act, halfway full the glass or halfway empty? Somehow we battle hard on A division, on youth hockey. We still make it. But on the other hand, I'm really happy to introduce you to these two guys. So we got first time in history, for Swiss hockey, the number one draft, Nico Ischia, a couple of years ago. And last season, the best NHL defender was Roman Josi, nominated and won the trophy as a Swiss. And if I put up 10 seconds of hockey, you can ask, is this related to do you use hockey?
Want to consistently win hockey games. So good job again by that line.
Ekholm gets some middle ice. Hands off, a spin move by Josi. Now he'll drive it right to the net. Centers it, they score! What a play! Roman Josi, highlight type of play, and Ryan Johansson puts it into the back of the net. It's 2-0.
Okay, give it to Josi. Spin around right in the middle, and then he takes it down. He's not even looking, but he knows Ryan Johansson, his back door. Look, he right there, peripheral vision. Now he's going to get a space, create a passing lane, and then Ryan Johansson elevates that puck.
So again, my question, first of all, I'm happy to have them, these guys, bring these heroes down to use hockey. That's one thing. And if we could go deep into, did you see this defender on the blue line? He wasn't at all there. How much confidence he cared, how skilled on skill-wise, of course, but how confident he is to go down as an attacker. And that's even the first reflection I do in our structure. How we can start on youth hockey, how we have to start, and what's the mentality to have maybe outcome 15 years later as such a great defender. Not going into too much anymore, but yes, it is related to youth hockey as well, to make it open, to encourage him to do things like Roman Josi is doing now on top level.
Want to consist.
So to put that together as a picture of Swiss ice hockey, we have ask him to be the role model. He is a wonderful role model guy for the national, for the country. So bring up guys, they really stand for something. 100% committed to the thing they do. This has an influence and an idea or a power into use and development as well. So again, where are we going? How we develop? We are always challenged against the top nation to someday to beat them. That's about Swiss hockey every day. And yes, we are a hockey nation. This is the great thing. Again, events. We put this guy up on youth hockey events. We have some giveaways, some gadgets. We put that even for young kids together. But we want to run. Unfortunately, last championship in Switzerland 2020 couldn't be held. But we're ready to hold the under 18 men's and ladies, and hopefully we're considering to apply for World Championship 2026. So if there are any questions, put them up now on the chat. Johan will be the moderator. If not, let's meet on 26 and somewhere in Switzerland and talk it over again. So this is about the thing, and I'm trying to switch now from AHF model to my presentation on Swiss ice hockey. That's about the idea for this 60, 70 minutes about an overview of long-term development, the concept behind what's about Swiss-made hockey, what we see behind it. You see the expression foundation. I don't know, you might use some other terms. That's okay. And maybe I'm not always correct with translation of the slide. I'm not correct with English, but that's our language. But maybe a little story behind the scenery. I was once down in South Africa to support and having speech on development hockey. And I was kind of embarrassed about my language, my English, because at that time, a US hockey guy was the national team coach. Perfect English, of course. But so I was shy and saying, oh, my English is not that good. But he answered me and gave me great confidence. He said, that's why I like it. You keep it simple. So make good things, in a simple way. So you guys, I don't know how your English is, might catch the best way you can. And if not, feel free to put up again the questions on the chat. So we're gonna have a chance to, at the end, to maybe answer your inputs or your questions. I go through about four fields of foundation, what it means and how we work on it. It could be a seminar by itself about what you might know or you have established as a long-term athlete development program. We have this concept format as a talent way, and we go on less on age level defining content. We go on several skill level concept level, I should say. Foundation, as you see, I come up with more information. It comes to talent, then he becomes a senior, an elite player, and the mastery, the top-down vision from the best players we have down to the recruitment hockey. By side, it's going the talent way into the high performance, but overall we define what is the topic, what are the key criteria about developing in a fun sport and not professional sport overall as well. I think this is an important thing to somehow establish. If we come up to like big messages, you might be through all to this as well, but I think it's really important to have it in mind all time, to reflect sometimes, I'm into that when I'm facing or mirroring my daily work. So ability and responsibility to make decision. So I get back to your Romagnosi's clip. Why he's doing this? And this is so much with confidence, with tolerance in the way as a coach, give him a chance. And ability comes through experience. So try and error. The great philosopher and didactic master, Albert Einstein, he said, if you never fail, you never try something. So where is the time to try and to do errors? It's use hockey. Give him this freedom to do it. Autonomy and initiative. It's based on the philosophy we ran about education, that it has to come from the player themselves. And this is kind of start all over at the recruitment. Give him the freedom to be in or not in. That doesn't mean he becomes a great player or not. Give him the time maybe to dream. Give him the time to catch these things up, and he will come up. And when if he's in, then we win. Win as a hockey sport, win as a coach. And the energy is of course, is built on self-esteem. So I could talk on and on. You get these slides anyway as a handout later on. So if there is a question to some other statement, feel free, of course, later, or put it up by written, or I go to the next slide overall. Swiss-made hockey is kind of course, we build it up from, as you see, foundation, bottom up, but we have this top-down vision as well. What is the best player needs for tomorrow, what they can deliver, what they do. And this is part of the concept to bring down to youth hockey as well. And we had this brochure about education, what we focus on, what is really the key message and the atmosphere, split it into guidelines in several athletes developments areas. You see, the personality is such a great thing, and it's not even hockey development. And I would encourage you guys to make sure that this message is came across in every way to the parents. We develop personalities. It's the fitness, of course, of athletics in several stages. But yes, game behavior. What is the game about? What is my focus and how we deliver the game? What is the implementation of the game into the overall concept of development? These are all these guidelines by side technique and tactics. Don't forget that. Get back sometimes, focus, mirroring your behavior you're doing. That's always good. Not losing the big picture on daily work. I would like to go to four areas of success in sense of foundation, as we call it, as again, foundation as the term of recruiting. And there is recruitment somehow, how we can, what kind of things we bring up and how good we are in growing the game in numbers of players. But it's not only this, it's the quality management. I like to talk how we run the thing, the daily work with the guys they join in. So important. Registration is something, but next day coming to the quality of recruitment work. Based on the big picture concept foundation as a development program long-term. And let's give us some thoughts about education, the role of the coach. We know, of course, you know, but I just show you how we think in this area from Swiss Ice Hockey.
Über die Hockeyschule sind alle Gielen und Mädchen ab 4 Jahren herzlich eingeladen, erste Hockey-Atmosphäre zu schnuppern. Gelernt wird es einmal eins, aber der Unterricht lebt von der Atmosphäre und von der Gesamtheitserlebnis. Von den leidenschaftlichen Trainern, die Freude vermitteln und das Feuer für den packenden Sport in den Kinderherzen entfachen.
Okay, it's not about the word. I know you might don't pick it up, the German, but what I want to show here is about bring the heroes down to make them dream. So we do it in several activities. Of course, the promotion overall, what is hockey, to bring this emotion to parents and kids and to have him this great game as an idea of, this is a great thing for my kid. Not about hockey and career, but with these guys to dream, that's maybe a lifetime event with a pro player. Give him the shirts, all these things. That's kind of how we like to implement or get kids more and more involved with our hockey. We have by side like little draws. It's more than, as you might see, it's more than just a hockey practice, how we can make fun of these for the kids and then somehow the relation to hockey as as I said, there is a competition. We put these kind of things together with an event, with an invitation with a national team. We had competition ongoing that for some reason, the national team or pro players coming down to some ice rinks, not pro rinks, of course, and just give them a touch. And hopefully they dream and keep signed in our hockey. So before I give you more information about, here you see the top slide we have, and as well you see the language is based on how we can approach the language to the kids, not to the parents. This is maybe the symbol of this kind of draw. I would like to invite you for a little questionnaire. You can start up your handy. Johan, you're gonna help the guys up to get ready for Mentimeter. As you see with the following called here, I would like to, of course, know your experience or your thoughts on a few questions. Johan, you take over.
You can connect to, it's written in the chat, you can connect to menti.com, use the code, and then you will see the questions coming up. In this way, we can exchange some ideas. So, and then Marcus can open his slides.
Yes, if I'm ready, Johan, is that correct? You see Mentimeter already?
We see Mentimeter already.
So give me just key words about what's important, what comes in your mind to have a successful recruitment. Of course, maybe we need more explanation, but let's put this kind of things together. I like the slide so far. The big word is in the top, on the top is a big and great. I see passion and energy. Yes, it comes. Maybe we could even discuss this, the energy by side that the coaches delivered to the kids on joining his fun to them, and even the parents to have them involved. So if they can live fun within the recruitment program, how wonderful this would be. Games instead of drills. Great message so far to the delivered practice, I would say. I'll wait a couple seconds more. Lots of statements, and they're all the same. Kind of, and you see, and I'm so happy that you put up this fun environment as a top criteria. Hopefully, and sometimes in Switzerland, we're good in seminars, but if I see or if I catch guys on the field, they're too much into the game and the maybe the efficiency part of recruitment overall. So again, this is doing this, even if we know it, that's great to do it time by time. Thank you very much. I think I'm gonna jump, even if it's not 100% full. But next question is, what is for you more important or the most important? Registration of new kids, having great program to sustain the kids in hockey, or having great leagues as a role model to have a famous hockey? So I tease you a little bit and get your priority just to have a free and open picture so far. Not everyone gave an answer so far, but we wait a little moment. I interpretate this slide so far. Yeah, we see that probably two areas are important, but having great programs is a key overall. Thank you. I go to next and ask you about some key factors. Tell me the importance of information to parents. Is that only till they register? Do we have to keep them out to have a hockey atmosphere? Kid Smile, we already get some information. What is about the tactic, the basic tactics to do? Is this important to stimulate curiosity about giving new things and learn to win? So again, maybe it's just a visualization of our thoughts. We had it in some terms, but I'm happy to see that just again, as a confirmation of your work, if you stand for this kind of answer as well in your recruitment work or recruitment activities, then I want to be happy. Of course, they're gonna build up some implementation of tactic patterns of game behavior through the game themselves, but it's not the goal set on an early age level. And of course, learn to win, you give the answer, of course, by yourself. Wonderful. Now, maybe the question in your country. If you look at your country's activity or your local, if you don't know about the country, then you come up about where you work or where you do your activity about registration project. Is what a kind of, you have great things, are you happy with? Do we have the best program we could, or is this okay, good? So give a little quality message out of your situation you're into in sense of recruitment hockey. And last but not least, what is your statement about the experience and the qualified coaches? I don't know if there is any ideas or is it working or do we stuck and there is no answers at all. Give me just 10 is, oh, we're fine. We're happy with, and I think we're good on that. If a one, if you say, oh my God, we didn't do that. Do we have quality management ideas, how we mirroring our work? Johan, you might put in an answer. I don't know if this is not working here.
I think we put in the answers already, Marcus.
Yeah, but it's not transmitted it. I don't know why, but anyway. Okay, let's maybe go to next slide in sense of and we have then a chance to overall to discuss this anyway when I go to next slide. And if I put this again up, the two pillars of the foundation success is, again, registration. I want to kind of divide this registration. Of course, how we can bring them to the hockey is one thing. What do we have? And the second, I call it conservation. How we can keep them? Because I know something. Guys, kids, they never complain. They just don't show up anymore. And even so, if they not get the support and the fun or the convincement of parents, they're gone anyway. So I would now let you guys think under small group about how your situation is in behalf of this two section. We have a 15-minute windows. What it means for you, registration, conservation, to separate these. Share your ideas, what you do in your country. Might give them some ideas. And if there is a statement of the group, I let you up to you guys. If there is question out of the group, quarter hour, then put it on the chat that Johan will collect it. But it's a free discussion overall. We put them in small groups about these two, registration, what is it is about, where we focus, how good you are. And let's keep it on not too long story for each guys. Make everyone have a speech, a voice. So in 15 minutes to share these two parts before I come up to show you guys what we think and how we ran on Swiss ice hockey in these two areas, the hockey here in the country. Thank you, 15 minutes, and I give over to Johan to organize it.
Okay, so as Markus said, we will break up in some small breakout rooms for 50 minutes. Just share your ideas. It's about what is happening in your country on recruitment. It's getting the players to register them. And then, as Markus calls it, conservation or retention. So just share your ideas. If you have ideas, you can always share them on the chat, but it's more to communicate with each other. So 50 minutes in the chat room.
Yeah, there was some great conversations, some great dialogue. I jumped in and listened to a couple of different rooms. I don't know, maybe some spokespeople from the different rooms would like to mention maybe one thing that they would take away from the conversation. And as Markus said at the beginning, if wants to share ideas and get people to share ideas, and hopefully that it will stimulate some thought and some motivation to take a new idea they learned here today back home with them. With anybody, I was in room number one, and I think it was number five or six also.
Anybody? Yes. Thank you, Kevin. When I can do a suggestion, please give this message short and with some keywords to the chat, and Johan collect it. Then we can come up at the end again. And I saw on my behalf, everyone likes to have more numbered play license in hockey. Yeah, that's correct. And what is maybe, and I can deliver some ideas what we do, how to grow this licensed player. But by side about this conversation room, I see guys, they don't like to talk. Jan told me they kind of guys left the session. Okay, that's always your decision. But I think we're going to do improve. We're going to do educate and make experience of this way of education. And I'm coming up with some key message on my belief on education. So be free, practice it. And even as a rule, you could say in the first group, guys, I'm not into that. Can I listen to you guys in the group? Why not? Give the message to the group, some other talks, and you're a great listener. But it would be nice if everyone can join comfortably. But anyway.
Markus, can I say one thing? The consistent, some consistent comments were equipment, access to beginner equipment for young players and beginner players. Consistently, I heard people saying that they have hand-me-down equipment or, as a player moves on, they hand that equipment down, but it's hard to get their hands on equipment. And then the cost to play hockey, or at least the perceived cost, where football is so prevalent around the world and other sports and in most of our countries, ice hockey isn't the number one sport. So the fear of it being expensive and the fear of travel. One good thing I did start to hear in each of the rooms I visited is minimizing travel and not running a long way from home to play, and more local games and combination of small area games or, cross ice games with more people, with people to keep that cost down and that fear of traveling for the new parents to go running hours away on a weekend. So to me, the consistent message was enough equipment, the cost and accessibility of that equipment, and then the time and the cost to travel and run all over the place. So that seemed pretty consistent. And I think something everyone in the world faces, but it's great to hear people that are focusing on that and trying to get that under control and communicate that to parents to overcome that objection.
Okay, that sounds good. And maybe I can do some comments during I go on through my slides. So again, at the end, we have another time frame to maybe talk about your questions as well. If I put this into this again, these two pillars, two areas, I want to emphasize the motivation, the play instinct, the equipment. Of course, it has to be, and it has to be announced how easy you can maybe start. And of course, if you can deliver the easy start equipment, it shouldn't be a burden about financing, just to make the first experience on ice. Communication, it kind of campaigns, but we have to address the parents and bring this game over to the parents. I believe we may be too much on the tunnel of hockey. Again and again, we should deliver the great education through this team sport. There is no other way or no better chance as in youth hockey to set goals and work for goals, to reach them and not reach them, as it is a key criteria on business side, to be part of a social group for a goal. Such a wonderful life skill message could it be through hockey delivered to the parents. They want to bring the kids to hockey. And of course, the animation part within project, I'm coming up with more how we do it. That's important as well, to make him dream, as I said, with heroes, to having the fun part so he's engaged to try more. But on the conservation, and I see talking about the content, it's about learning climate. It's not a focus on the game or the efficiency of the game. It's about how playful, how wonderful I can make improvement. The kid should be awarded for improvement, not for results. The feeling good part, as I said, if we miss that, we're gone. We stuck. They don't show up, go to next sport, which is okay, or they don't do sport. So and of course the emotional part, as I said, with events as a memory, as a life moment he enjoy. And this is related to hockey. So we have a chance, we keep on our programs. A few statements. What is important for me, we should try to understand the children's world the best we can, because we cannot emphasize enough, this is not an adult program. They think differently, they act and respond differently. This at least gives us a push all time, is this level and age appropriate learning what we establish. It's so hard. I'm crazy 4 years away from that. But if I don't do that, I'm kind of lost. So do it again and again. What is the child, and maybe how to feel this child, what is feeling about what we're doing. The language and the instruction should be all time in a trust and positive way. All time, I emphasize. It can't be at the tournament is different because it's nice to have this trophy. No, it can't be. It's all time encourage feeling good, because I want to have them next day as well. The content should be challenged. Yes, give him task. It's not going to make it, let them try. And if it's not going to make it again, there is not the decision made if this is going to be the pro player or not. The we feeling, the social moment, do you implement ideas or games or activities they feel as a group, because they need that. These, again, in my symbol about treatment or learning atmosphere is a little bit a metaphor. This picture down on their size, having them as a group, feeling good. This is for me, I love this picture so much. Here, just two ideas about content delivering. It's not about practice, as we know, from downsized from pro hockey. It's about the game. They go through, they catch up a task, they try again, they jump on, they go back, and on and on. This is for us the way 5 years old kids gonna think and maybe have a playful game atmosphere in sense of this game, not in the sense of scoring and beating an opponent. And of course, through the website, we can put all these up for the parents to invite and join this information, as I said, as a selling point, as a promotion point of our sport. Let's go to next. This is a Swiss hockey day. What can you do maybe in your region, in your local situation, or in your country? We can establish one day is a recruitment day. We stop the pro leagues and send the pro player into these fields. You see the spot of the professional player. They work with balloons, with chairs, with the kids. That's event. That's joyful, and it's something else than win the game of activity. And I tell you, if you can spread out and do it the same moment, you might get media response, which is a great promoter for the hockey, if you can do it all over the country, same way, same day. Just as an idea. I heard in a group about hockey goes to school. If school is not coming to hockey, do we have a chance to go to the school? Yes, we don't, we don't have ice at the schools. Or yes, we can implement this fun part of the hockey in the school. So this is the idea we run through several years already, that we go with equipment and do a few things in the school. We bring the bus with the equipment into the school area. If there is three party involved, it has to be the teacher, of course, addressed to the age level. We see a recruitment. It has to be Swiss hockey, and it has to be the regional local club who do the follow-up after this event in the school. We bring the equipment, we have it all, and do whatever we can do close to ice hockey in the classroom, in the gym hall, and then as a follow-up, next lesson of sport as a school lesson could be the ice session with a club coach. This is the idea. Of course, it needs equipment. It needs long ways to go, depending on the situation. But if you can implement with little thing, it doesn't have to be such sufficient equipment. But if we do that, we put some paper helmet, the Skoda helmet, you might remember from World Championship. We have recruitment paper helmet. We put that together in the class. We have pictures. We do puzzles. Then we go into the gym hall, activity like on an ice field. And then as a follow-up, we have the invitation for the teacher to be held an ice session with an expert of a club or the recruitment guy. This is about a few ideas, again, to put in place, like this desire, everyone probably going to mention it, that we like to have more kids involved. Let's move on to the next area about development. I mentioned it, this FTEM, Foundation Talent Elite and Mastery. And I've talked about, is that related to recruitment hockey, the star profile, the scouting concept we run in Swiss ice hockey with older ages? If I bring this up, the foundation we separate to in three different levels. And it comes to the education level, the way we educate, and just we should have talked more and more, of course. Come up to me, I share with you with pleasure. For F1 is the starting, to discover, to explore. It's not about teaching and exercising. Make him hungry, make him curiosity and feel good. F2 as a upper level is exercise, more on stationary work, of course, by doing the skill elements in several adapted task levels. So everyone is kind of challenged, but still on a fun atmosphere, of course. And then after in F3, finally, we reach the structure of structured weekly work in a club. Practice, go home, there is a game at the end, something like that. But that has to be teach and be free to learn through the F3 level. So you see, it's a content concept once, but by side education concept as well, implemented is in this three different level of foundation, as we call it. We can organize things. This is from the hockey day about, you know, and see, this is has, I don't see any two goal against, goal for. It's about, sorry, I put them on again. And whatever you have free for ice rink, as better you organize, they're ongoing with things you don't believe they become a hockey player at the end, but it's age appropriate and skill appropriate. That's the thing. And the far part with some guys helping out, that's as I mentioned it before. You might had this discussion already in several former webinars. I don't know if you're in, but what we have different format and tournament, as Kevin mentioned. You can implement this within the club, within one or two neighbor clubs, and do the tournament. It doesn't have to be a national championship, of course. But the thing I want to bring up is if this game should be, for me, implemented in the concept of content. What is the main focus when I want to get out of the game? And if it's touching puck, handle the puck. So we have to organize or set up game situation as a here and two and two. Many pucks around give many, many possibilities for having a puck contact. If it comes to small principles, given goals on a situation more game like two sets, then we have three on three on the under 11. And if the same thing of under over age or older ages is under 13, we go on a 4-on-4 two side. Again, what Kevin said, we keep more players involved. We have a tournament, could it be two teams and split it out? We have eight guys on one roster, here eight guys. Again, these are the formats. I'm not going into deep now about this, but to show you, we try to think over first, what is the goal on this age level to emphasize? And appropriate to this goal setting on the development concept, we put game situation kind of tournaments in place. This is the star profile. I couldn't translate, but you see about personality, athletics, and mental. So many things. But now my question, does it has to be relevance to recruitment hockey? This is the scouting sheet we ran by under 14, under 15, we start to deal, or what should I say, go through by scouting the players. I show you here that you don't need to read, but these are the same topics. And we put on F1, discover, explore, and make it happen. And then we have in all these different activities, education level, explore. So again, we set up a language of scouting, which is based to the development concept, and the development concept is based to the selection concept and can start at all age, but of course appropriate age run by appropriate age atmosphere is exploring the things. So that's, we're really deep in that, and maybe I can bring the message across how really it shouldn't be like just implemented or improvisate this content and run practice. If it's based on a big picture on long term, that helps to have good programs, I believe. If it comes to quality management, what is the label? It's a quality management. We address what we think is good. Swiss ice hockey. And then the club can measure what he's doing. Maybe he gets some ideas out of it and he get challenged and motivated to go through this kind of checklist. And we put some money into that. And at least we have a chance to give money to those they do good things. By side on registration, we have through the internet tool a good stat. You see that the development of license number. You see here we have the silver medal. So we see big events gonna have an influence into recruitment. I'm not going into the stats itself. I want to show if we have this quality controlling, we can discuss next steps, what we can do the best way for the future, having numbers. Here is just an example as very interesting. The small clubs, they grow of numbers of license, and the big club, they were sustainable or they go back. So what does it mean for us as a hockey guy? What can we do? What should it be done? I'm just emphasize this stats gonna help us to maybe create the future the best way as a support for a recruitment program. If I come up with what kind of criteria we kind of address to this label. So I want to show and share you just really quick about the main topics. You see in German, there is explanation how we vote, how we grade. That's not an important, but we split all the activity into main criteria. The intro of the hockey, do you deliver hockey schools? And now you see into the label, we mentioned this activities. Are you into the tournament? Are you doing Swiss High Hockey Day? Are you running Hockey Goes to School? Then we support this. They can, on the website, I show you later, then they can say, yes, we do better. And we put some investments, could it be a gadget, like equipment thing, could it be even money-wise, that's what we do to support those, they really focus on good education programs. Of course, the coach education, joining the webinars, being involved with new things and idea that we award. So we have them on this seminars, of course, through the benefits out of it. Game operation, how you ran the program. Sometimes it's maybe hard, they can maybe a bit cheating, I don't know. That's based on trust, but we do the trust and they have a good overview about to have these all elements. Equipment, do you deliver equipment? Can you help? Do you establish like a change of equipment through parents? So we put the ideas up on this roster and at the end, we give them points and we will give them benefits. That's kind of a slide you don't need to read, of course. That's the administration part of the website. So we on the left side, I have the clubs. I have the criteria, I bring it up, and here the side is the explanation. I give them how many points. They have to bring up like files to prove. Give me the hockey school invitation, give me the parents campaign as a picture, upload it, and that's fine. If I... just a short introduction. It's not about I think to learn this website, but I'm going into now as a website, and this is maybe the great thing. It's not about distance. If you can maybe start with the same system, one, two simple criteria. If you do that, that's a positive stream, I believe, because you award for doing good. We had in the past in Swiss hockey, like rules, and if you don't do it, then it's not good, then we might give him a fine. So that's a negative spiral. But here I can say, okay, you as again, you can first of all, the club can be measured, and I show them in several criteria how you are compared with the best, compared with the average. And you don't believe the big club, SC Bern, I showed the picture in the beginning. We win because the CEO mentioned these ranking and asked the play and asked the responsible where we are and what we can do to be better. It's not about the ranking on youth hockey overall. It's this ranking to establish, to motivate, to do next step. It's a tool which we implement since for many years. I just show you, this is kind of web-based on many criteria, coaching, but you see different color. You can here put them in intro to the game. You can select kind of criteria, but again, it doesn't have to be so sophisticated for you guys, but you have several criteria. They work on it, they're doing it. And here is the administration part. We run and say, this is okay. Yellow, yeah, it's not okay. I should need more information. And if it's done, we put it on green automatically. So we can interact on quality management through the website, no distance, no limits on that. And again, we have several family of labels we address. It's a recruitment for every club. We support these guys. It's about 110 clubs running. By side, the webinars we put in place as a criteria. If there is question, maybe at the end. I want to go through to the fourth and last area of success in my point of view about learning is confirmation. Confidence is an important thing. That's why I hope you get out of this session as well with confidence and confirmation. But education is built on this structured learning. That's the module we run on a daily work at the field. But I really truly believe this is a part you're into. Congrats as well again, into one topic session, two webinars. But learning is through sharing things. That could be on the webinar side, as we do all over the world. What about, do you do it in the club? Sometimes I feel like coaches are hiding their knowledge. And they're maybe ashamed to show and have a question to others. If you can establish a coach-to-coach, somehow simple system, hey, my friend, coach, upper level, can you join me for a practice and give me some kind of feedback? Because you guys, coaches, are poor guys. They just deliver. They get the yelling, maybe parents at the end, but who is giving them positive feedback? And kind of tell them in a different approach of watching his activity to improve would be a wonderful thing. Is not related to money. And of course, the individual development through experience. Guys, try it. Try and do it. And then you can make errors and improve as well. Or to sharing with question. Again, question is the best way to learn, I believe. And I'm going to answer every question whenever it is. That's confident for my side to get in that question. So those guys, they run this thing in sense of education. I think you can improve. So try and error. And transform all these things to your field. Question, research, and innovation is about the study, the formal learning through the and coach, and this mirroring your own task. That would be my triangle of education. What we have. Of course, several countries maybe have only daily work. That's fine. We have a diploma structure for high level. But what is important, and maybe you can address just these special and awarded seminars for kids. That's the kids diploma structure we go through. And again, focus kit. the psychological part, how they think. It's hard, but do we have implemented in somehow support the coach? There may be, again, good guys, give him all the passion, but to understand the kids, we have to support them the best way we can. So we have implemented the extra kids education diploma structure for this age group. And last but not least, I want to show you with e-learning. That's a big word since many years, but in sport, not too much implemented. I show you guys here a German lesson, and I show you the structure. First of all, I hope I get into what we establish now as a, I think, a huge potential for us to address to coaches over distance, to give him an extra session. He can choose the time. Safety game. I just give you an idea about these four didactic sections. Intro could be with picture, with some content, with some to motivate them for the lesson. If we go to the next level, we have this explore for the coach, and could be even for an athlete defined in a special way, the lesson. Then we have clips, of course, running. You have equipment. You can fill out in a nice atmosphere. Oh, that's not too good yet. I can try again. Fill out, they get a feedback. You get here to fill out. But it's not about wrong or right, just to prove, to make a stimulus in sense of these topics. Here we can go over it at the topic and see. We have a third level structure, the study, then it comes to open, more open question. It becomes to more maybe clips. It's a huge potential on building up lessons in my belief. But here, that's the thing we try to implement on material, additional frameworks to download. And the check is a self-motivation to check about the topics. But if I go back to this session, I give you about just 5 minutes. It's 18, so 5 or 6 minutes to... If those, they want to go into this learning, this is an English lesson about my sport. This is a kind of idea. If you like to have it, then you get it, because the link is for free for the world who join it. We could make this English lesson, and maybe Johan, you put the link in place. Those guys, they just want to watch me. I show a little bit of this lesson, and those, they want to try quick to get in. It's about a 1 hour session. You could go to these same level stages with a link you get in the chat. Johan, correct?
Yes, the link is in the chat box, so you can try by yourself, or you can just follow a small presentation by Markus. Okay.
So again, I leave it up to you. 5:25, we were into to finalize the lesson. For those, they go by their own way. Again, it's the intro I show you about what is our sports. Again, we have this movie. You can put it in a full screen. I might not doing it. Intro is the motivation. You fill out easily. You get the feedback. So you see the intro is about expected 10 minutes, the explore part about our hockey. You see picture here, he has to, as a game-like situation, what kind of hockey family we have, all these, we put the picture into the right sport. Oh, that was too fast, try again, you can do. About function, you see whatever you're interested, you see some commentary. So it's, of course, it's up to you what level this should be, what you can, it might implement this in a coaching clinic. we give these lessons in advance to coaching lessons, starter coaches to go through, and then we discuss it in the coaching clinic. That's just one other format. The study, again, with some movie clips about speed, he watched it. So I'm just like to, he does some remarks and get a feedback about what he saw. If I can motivate to join this lesson carefully by the time you have an open 1 hour window to go through and maybe think of how we can establish kind of or improve or add these things to our coaching agenda or to deliver to parents. Of course, we could adapt the lessons into smaller or easy way to go. But at the end is the questionnaire could be very simple, motivated, and we have the chance to submit that to be the as a response. And of course, we do even for athletes having lessons and give him a gadget. Give him a giveaway as an award. So that's a new learning we try to implement on level of coaches and athletes as well. I was too fast to catch up some content, but if you see, and you see it on the slides, if some guys are motivated to go through, we have four languages established for us, but this lesson with this code, you get into the English version. But again, if you see this as a potential in your country and you see it could help, what about to think over this to translate in your own language, some kind of lesson, just to have it as a starting point to deliver our sport to some target groups. This is about learning. It's big part, and of course this, all these learnings and doing it is implemented in the label structure, and we award this as well through some points on benefits. I'm quite through to that, and I ask again if there is any question or remarks on your side. Johan, you're the moderator.
Yeah, Marcus. So I would before we wrap up, we go to some comments in the chat box, because I think it's interesting and we can also reply or give some suggestion and then have some small question and then you can wrap up. So we have in the chat box this comment, like, getting the kids into skating school or hockey school goes well. Having them join a real club is harder. So I would say or think that having an intermediate or hockey light could help you. You maybe don't register them immediately to hockey, but you could register them to a number of try hockey events. That could help. Instead of saying immediately you have to pay the full Monty, try to convince them by it's important they come back. It's important to have them back and to let them try again. So it could be an idea to just have this 10 try hockey tickets. And maybe then they will register, because maybe then they are even more convinced. Any comment from your side, Marcus?
Yeah, of course, that's a kind of the burden when it comes to finance, as I heard. Of course, it's easy to say they don't finance them at the early beginning of a club membership. But if you need this money because you pay the ice, I would maybe try to give good information, and maybe I would kind of start to point towards the parents. How much you're gonna invest overall the kids for education, for getting ready in professional and to be a good person in life. And now you come up and see, this is what we deliver. We're not doing it on the ice, but we learn to making friends, to stand up for the friend. We learn about all these things. I'm not going into detail now, but just give them the message. The club is not just the ice and making athletes out of them. It's more than this. And if they consider about what they spend on school, of extra education and all this for getting them ready for life, for professional, maybe that's a great and cheap way to doing it through hockey.
Thank you. Then a great suggestion versus the cost is donate old equipment to the club so that it can be loaned to new players. As a suggestion, we in our in my home club, we always organize the second-hand market at the beginning of the season. And we had a system in which all equipment that was not sold or collected before 4 o'clock was kind of donated to the team. So exactly, if you find a solution, I also have to say that there is IHF equipment support. And I know that loads of equipment has been donated to M&As. Just as a small remark is how you deal with it. Because very often it's arrived to the club. And I see also questions from countries in which I know for sure that big amounts of equipment has been sent by IHF, but we never know how it was dealt with. And as Marcus already mentioned, you should have a program and you should have a clear plan what and how you will manage the equipment. Because very often the equipment was donated, it was used, but then, for example, the council or the board in their own federation is changing, and then all of a sudden all the equipment disappeared. So it's important to know that if equipment is donated, that it should be part of the M&A and that it should be available for a long time. What do you think, Marcus?
Yes, I know it's a hard part if it comes to cost. And again, as you said, this loan thing. So we put this as a criteria in the label. Do you establish once a month, once a week, early season, our kids, parents? You can might even involve parents to do in this and to promote, maybe give back old materials, something like that. I could imagine, and then think of, can we bring it in a club without having the full equipment? Can we even, as a club member, running these hockey school things in an early period, just to have them in, again, to stick with a club and see, whoa, that's a good thing. If we convince the kids in sense of joy and heart, and we convince the parents in sense of good atmosphere, fun atmosphere, kids is happy, and we have them, just maybe as a simple way, then we can move on. And then more and more with happiness and energy, we the parents find way to get the equipment necessary for older age level hockey.
Exactly. Then we have a suggestion about travel, play more regional games. I remember, Marcus, that a couple of years ago, maybe it's a little bit longer than a couple of years ago, but you came with this quote that parents in Switzerland were traveling 7 hours to play 20 minutes. And you said, we have to come with something stronger. It should be better. And it was about playing in a different format or playing more regional games.
Yes, I fully agree. You saw my format. Again, we break down the regular game more, even under 13. By the way, we have this 4-against-4, 2 fields, but we have the regular game as well. But this is always a challenge about having the same appropriate level on skill level, the teams. If you want to match them, then you go have a bigger way. But again, if this level is not the competition level and it's not deciding why, they can win. And then you do this small games in small area and club, you can organize the team better in an appropriate skill level to face them. This is the key, not the score at the end. To organize this same level within different small games area situations.
Okay, so we have another suggestion in a way saying, from my point of view, in our country, we need to be ready for recruitment 24/7, 365 days a year. One hockey day isn't enough for us. Ice hockey is a minority sport in our country. For sure, it's one of the things we have to say. A recruitment is fun, but it's hard work and it's a non-stop business. But in fact, Marcus, who is responsible for recruitment?
Good question. Thank you very much. I think everyone. We are a team. We are a team sport, and especially in recruitment, we were all involved. And of course, we can discuss, you can discuss in the club, who is running the promotion, who is running the communication with the parents, maybe, because we have good guys on laptop and speeches, and who is running the kids, who take care of the kids. But we have to be aware that we're a team. And if somebody's missing, we're all involved, because the outcome is joy, fun, and licensed player. Very simple. So make sure we discuss this. What could be your task? What is your strengths to doing it? But it's recruitment hockey is a hard work. Great appreciation for everyone who joins this activities or he's into. But it's responsible for all of us.
Okay. Thank you very much. So I think we can wrap up the session. I know you have a few more slides to conclude. So I would invite you to share the last slides and the comments as a wrap up for this session.
Sure. I'm just summarize. You saw a lot of slides about IDs, and again, sent through Johan. Contact me if there is more information needed or desired. I summarize, of course, with kind of these four or five messages. Recruitment is based on two pillars. Think of registration is one thing. Could it be because we were outside in sport in your country? But if you do something and you have a message and you go to people, then it's easy to grow, first step. Keep them in hockey, that's the second pillar we discussed. Four area of success, I said that the registration is management, quality management, don't forget to reflect, and based on concept of content and good coaches in sense of education. Again, stimulus, make them curiosity, make them curious, give them chance to explore something. That's the age, early age we can win. And if you put this up, he starts streaming hockey. And then I say, we won. If we start streaming, he starts streaming, he or her, then upper level, we always can do the skill and detailed education for the hockey game as a game. Quality management, again, it's not a controlling, it's a support and improvement. And through the award, as I said, coaches and all equipment, all these things somehow to put as a criteria to be good. And they like it to gain points in a good way for a good recruitment activity. Coach education is a key, still a key. You can implement in small groups as well. Don't forget that. That's a support and appreciation for the coaches. They on the field with the kids. So you saw a lot of things. Focus on the moment. That's a national team picture, but it's right perfect for me for recruitment. It's not about changing everything. Just if you figure out of this 1.5 hour session, one point you can maybe work on and adapt and implement in your situation, would be great. And I would be so happy if this is one point to move on. And of course, thank you very much. Foundation of all the work is appreciation. You guys, I appreciate you be here. Appreciate the parents, what they do, the helpers, and of course the kids having them. And I love this statement, trust as a five extremely demanding letters. Trust yourself, try, reflect, and then you do better. Make experience in campaign, in communication. If you don't try, if you don't fail, you never tried something. Trust and trust your helpers as well. In this sense, thank you very much for the time being with Swiss Ice Hockey the way we're doing. We have challenges as well. That's the state of the moment for us. And I wish you good luck. Thank you very much. As a team sport, I give back to Johan.
Marcus, great presentation. And as always, you will find the recording of the webinars on the IHF website or on YouTube channel. We had this question, would those webinars be removed after 1 year? They will be available on the IHF YouTube channel as well. We will be back in the beginning of August, so we take a little summer recess. So right after the summer break, we will announce a new series of Skills for All webinars. So to conclude, I want to thank Marcus for a great presentation. Thank you, Marcus, for the inspiration and the work. It is always some hard work to prepare all this. And also thank you all for your attention and time. Hope to see you after summer.